Hi guys, today we are going to see about how to set up a hacking lab, and we are going to do some attacks to get the backdoor of that operating system. So here in this 15 to 20 minutes lecture, we are going to know how to set up the virtual box and how to install the operating systems and how to do the attacks. This is the overview. So I am going to install the virtual box in my operating system, and then I am going to install Kali Linux, which is the best operating system for the Linux based operating system, to do penetration testings and vulnerability assessment. And this is one of the best operating system for the cybersecurity experts. And there is a similar to others, there are some other operating systems are there like Parrot and Backtrack and some other, but this is also one of the best one as my view. So I am going to install the VirtualBox, then I am going to set up the operating systems, then I am going to do attack on that operating system. Let's go. I am going to install the VirtualBox first. If you go to Google VirtualBox, download VirtualBox, just click that, you will get the first link, then click that. After clicking that, you will get like this page. Then go to the Windows. I am using the Windows operating system. So then go to the Windows host. If you are using the Linux operating system, you have to enter the apt get install VirtualBox. So it's depend upon the what distribution of Linux you are using. On that base, if you do the Google, you will get the what command you have to enter that to install that VirtualBox in your operating system. So then after installing the operating system, it was installed here. Then after I clicking the install, it will open and it will see install anyway. So this is an open source operating system. I already installed it. That's why it is saying the remove or the repair. So I'm going to enter the cancel. This is a very simple method to install the VirtualBox. It is very user friendly. To do the attacks in the, it looks like the real-time environment. This is one of the best way to do some attacks on the different, because there is nothing happened if it have anything problem for that operating system. If it is crashed, there is no problem because it is in virtual environment. We have to reinstall it again. We have to install the another operating system. So let's go to the VirtualBox. In my VirtualBox, there's a Kali Linux I'm using and Windows 10, and it's the experimental and Metasploit Table 2. Now I'm going to show you the Kali Linux. I'm going to do perform penetration testing through Kali Linux. Then I'm going to attack on Metasploit Table 2. So this is a only short lecture. In that I am going to see just how the VirtualBox is useful for the hackers to do the attacks, to test their skills, is it exploitable or not, to do the practice, to get more proficiency on their field. So now I am going to open the Kali Linux. If you want to know how to install the Kali Linux in the VirtualBox, there are so much content is available in the Google, just try it. Otherwise, I am going to prepare one video for the how to install Kali Linux in the VirtualBox, how to install the Windows operating system, or how to install Metasploit Table 2. These are everything will be I am going to show you in different parts. But overview, I am going to show you about the present session is to how to set up hacking lab through VirtualBox and how to do attacks and how to perform attack. This is a basic class, and we are going to see in a few seconds how to set up these all things. So let's go to the Kali Linux. It is my Kali Linux. So this is the version 20 latest version. So I am going to see what is my IP address. My IP address is 10.0.2.5. This is my IP address. So I am going to check what is the IP address of the Metasploit Table 2. What is the IP address I have to contact? Just now I installed this operating system. So here the IP address is 192.168.1.121. Okay, here the IP address is 192.168.1.121. So I am going to perform the first of all, the hackers do the scan. Through Nmap, we are going to do some basic scan. Nmap-sc-code is my favorite command to do the penetration testing. This is my best Nmap command. I will do this when I am doing the penetration testing on the different operating systems in the real time. I use this command. Mostly I use this command. I save my time by doing scan through these commands, because it will give the finding the default vulnerabilities, and it will give the clear information about the version, and it will give the operating system details. And it will do some fast means is a time t for time 4 1 2 3 4 5. I will mention 4 to give the maximum genuine result about that operating system. Now we are going to do we are doing scan about Metasploit table 2. Let's see how much it performed. 97% it has done within the spam of within 1 minute. It has done 97%. Just it has given the full result. What is there in that operating system? See here, lot of information it has given. That's why I like this command. This is the one of the best command in for me. So here it is there. 21 TCP open port. And VSF TPD 2.30. The version as well as given, and it is open, and it is FTP service, and it is open. Anonymous FTP login is allowed. If there is any folders are there, we are able to see, and we are able to download, we are able to delete. So we are going to see what is other details is there. 22 TCP is open, and 23, 25, 53, 80, 110, and a lot of other open ports are there. And MySQL also opened in this on that system. MySQL is running, and there is so much information it has given through Nmap. We got this much information. This is enough for the basic scanning, and is enough for the system where it is not secure or secure. We will say within the minute span of the minutes, we will say that, and we are able to do some attacks and perform the. We are able to perform successful exploitation on that system to get the backdoor access. Let's see, we got this much information, and what is the running guest operating system is a VirtualBox. Obviously it is in the VirtualBox, so it will show the VirtualBox. So let's see. So I am taking this one. This one is a basic one. This one is the first one. So I am doing now today, I am doing attack on this to get the backdoor of that Metasploit Table 2 operating system. So what I will do, I want to do the attack through Metasploit Table framework. I am opening the Metasploit Table framework. In the Kali Linux, there are lot of tools are there. Everybody say there are 600 tools, 500 tools, there are more than 300 tools. Yes, there is a lot of tools are available, which is in hundreds. I don't know the exact number, what is the 600 or 300, but there are lot of tools are there. It is in hundreds, because I am using more than 70 to 80 tools in the real-time environment. The famous tools are Nikto and OpenVAS, lot of tools, so WPS scan and NetDiscover, Nmap, and so much tools are there. But I use some tools to do attack, but 70 to 80 tools I use in my real time environment, to do attack and get the vulnerabilities and do the attacks and get the backdoor access on that system. So now Metasploitable framework is open. Now we have to do some search in Metasploitable about the VSFTPD. This version, let's see. Oh yeah, we got this exploit is available in the Metasploitable framework. This is luckily we got the this framework is available in the Metasploitable framework, and we'll try. I'm going to try. I'm not sure about it will exploit it or not, but I'm going to try to get the access on that Metasploitable system to get the access from the backdoor. Let's try. Use exploit backdoor, and I'm going to show options. What are the options are there? Just there is only two options are there. Let's try Argos 192.168.1.121. This is the my Metasploitable 2 operating system's IP address. So I am going to see. This is my operating system. This is the open port is available. This is the name of the exploit, model backdoor, and privileged AS Metasploitable framework. Everything we got here. And I am going to run. I will try to. I did exploitation. Yeah, it's created the backdoor service. Here it is. It's created the backdoor service, and we are lucky to that we got the session open. Here it is. The session is open. So I am going to check what applications are there, what folders are there. Yes. These are the folders are available in the Metasploitable 2. Oh, I want to create one folder. For you, I want to create one folder. So let's see. Well, let's see where is the Metasploitable 2. Show Metasploitable 2. Yes. These are the folders. What are the folders? Bin, dev, pond, lost, root, sys, where, proc, user. What are they? Same bin, boot, user, everything. Now I want to create one folder in the root. So cd root. Yes. There are 1, 2, 3, 4. Four roots are there. So now I'm going to create one folder. Your system is hacked. Yes. We got hacked. Okay. Your is one folder. Is one folder. Hacked is one folder. System is one folder. So we have created these many folders. Your system is hacked. So 1, 2, 3, 4 folders we have created. Let's check whether it is there or not. Yes, it is there. Because we are able to see that your system is there. What happened? It is not showing the cursor. Okay, I will see that because just now I installed this operating system. So we are able to see desktop hack, hacked is. Before that, there is only 2 or 3 folders are there. Now we are able to create it. So now I want to create again. KDAR. Hacking. So let's see. Yes. Is there any hacking? Yeah, right. Desktop hack, hacked, hacking. We created. That means we got the full access of that system from the Kali Linux system. We exploited successfully this vulnerability by using Metasploitable framework from Kali Linux. So this is the one of the basic practical we have pen testers. We have to do different types of attacks on different vulnerabilities. So this is the one of the FTP and version based attack. So we have to do some more attacks and some more, we have to find some more vulnerabilities on that setup, on that operating system. Is it maybe the Windows or the Metasploit Able 2 or the Kali Linux or the some other operating system? We have to find, we have to check whether the how many ports are open, how many, how much vulnerabilities are there, is it able to attack or not. If we are able to find the vulnerabilities, is it able to exploit it or not? Everything we have to do. It will take some time, but this is the basic vulnerability attack. So luckily we got this vulnerability and we did attack. Thank you for watching this session, and please friends, please support my channel and subscribe my channel and like my channel, because I want to share my my total experience in this channel to give the knowledge to the those who want to be expert in the cybersecurity field. I want to share my said knowledge. I want to share my knowledge to the others. They also be able to get good knowledge in this field. Thank you for your support and thank you for watching this video.